Thank you so much. Good morning, dear colleagues, dear friends, and those who are not yet my friends, hopefully will become it, or the others might still be my friends after I have spoken, because what I wanted to tell you, and I wish to tell you actually, is a little bit maybe controversial, might be wrong, but it goes back to my long experiences, which I have particularly got here in India. Before that, I was rather active since the early 80s in China and helping many friends there in building a good, from my viewpoint, very good IP system, patent system particularly. And here in India, I had in Hyderabad my start, so to say, of my, no, it was not a confrontation, the start of a conversation, of a dialogue concerning Indian patent law in 1995-96. It was at a WIPO conference here in Hyderabad, where I was invited to speak about a question similar to, can Indian generic pharmaceutical industry survive under TRIPS conditions? It was just the time when India was compelled to modify the patent law to the extent that pharmaceuticals got substance protection, which in Germany they never had in the times when I learned patent law or it was just being introduced. Germany had perfectly lived with method of manufacturing patents, and it was about these experiences. And I saw here that India is a country where the question which was so masterly this morning already explained the necessary balance between patents, which principally are monopolies, and free competition, where monopolies are an obstacle against free competition, is taken very seriously right from the beginning. And I would just like to remind you that I teach in Germany primarily also at the University of Bremen, but also at the Munich Intellectual Property Center, MIPLC, Munich Intellectual Property Law Center at Munich, which is a joint venture between the Max Planck Institute in Munich, I come immediately to that, and some other institutions. But the Max Planck Institute I'm talking about is the Max Planck Institute for Intellectual Property and Competition Law. Why did they put, you could say, force together competition and patent law? They did it really, and you see this even in the directorate of the Max Planck Institute in Munich, in order to bring a permanent dialogue between competition specialists, the promoters of free competition, and monopolists, the patent lawyers, into a fruitful structure, which actually finds its outflow in many of the PhD theses written there, in many of the discussions in the institute, in the conferences, etc. So there is a natural, I would say, competition between patent and competition law. Here today, and I have 20 minutes, now two or three are already gone, so I would like to restrict myself to more or less talking freely to you and dealing with the questions I have put together on this slide here in a summarizing speech of about 17 to 18 minutes now. The rest of my text, my slides, whatever is in the papers, I have to my great satisfaction seen, and you can read that, and it would be boring if I would try to put 24 slides, I think, into 20 minutes here. I could just hardly read the headlines, and you can read yourself. So I will try to explain a little bit to you what today the problems with the patent system from my viewpoint are, and my viewpoint is essentially based on my experiences as a practitioner under German and European patent law in Germany, but also on my experiences which I have as advisor and also working on their behalf, both big international companies like some who are very active here in India, like Microsoft or Intel. I do the major part of the European work, or of big Chinese companies, and I see the problems there. And I would like to come to my ideal vision of a reasonable, and I mean taking care of the necessary balance between competition and patent law, patent system. What my vision would be, based thereon.